Welcome everybody to this tutorial. This is the third time I'm recording this, so hopefully I'll get it right this time around. Today we're going to be going over how to make a black and white portrait in rawtherapee. So as you can see here, I just kind of set up my camera and I took this picture and I just had a light off to one side, so it looks kind of moody. And as you can also see, I haven't had a haircut in a couple months, and so I look kind of crazy. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started. First, just jump into an automatic lens correction. And then let me go ahead and increase the exposure. I don't want my face to be overexposed. This little white line here is this little peak. So I think that's probably about good. Let's increase the darks, the black there. And all right. I'm not going to worry about any sort of contrast or brightness or saturation. The only thing I am going to do is come over here to the color tab and turn on the black and white module. And then in the after curve, I'm going to put that on standard, and I'm going to mess with this a little bit. See if I can't get a more contrasty image. I think black and white photography is really, it can be really powerful if it's done right. And I'm not saying I know how to do it right, but I like this. Now the other thing you'll notice is all of this noise. So that actually can be a benefit, especially in black and white photography, but I'm gonna try and reduce that just a little bit. So let me increase the luminance here. Something like that. And I'm just looking right here in the bright parts of my face. And once I feel like my noise reduction is good on the bright parts of my face, I'm just going to open that in an external editor, which in this case is GIMP. Okay, so that's the version that we just made. I'm going to come back here and I'm going to increase the luminance again. Actually, I'm going to change the mode from conservative to aggressive. And now I'm looking in the dark parts of my face, and I'm trying to noise reduce that to a better look. I don't want to lose 100% of the noise, but I think something like that is probably pretty good. And then I'm going to open this one in the external editor as well. Okay, so we can see this is the noise reduced image that for the dark parts and the shadows, and this is noise reduced for the highlights. So I'm going to grab my shadow noise reduced image and just drag it on top of my my highlight noise reduced image, and then I'll just close that. So now we can see, I can turn this off, more noise, less noise, more noise, less noise. I'm going to duplicate the shadow noise reduced image, and then I'm going to come here to colors and invert, and then colors and levels. And I'm just going to, I'm only really worried about my face here. I'm not really worried about what's going on in the background. But yeah, I think that looks good. So I'll click OK. So what I've done here is I'm using this to create a mask. So now that I have this mask, I'll hit Control A to select everything, and Control C to copy it. I'll turn it off, and then I'll come here to my first noise reduced, shadow noise reduced image, and I'll just add in a mask and select that mask, and then hit Control V, and then hit the little anchor here. And what that's going to do is that's only going to apply, there we go, you can see that only applied the dark parts of the mask, or the dark parts of the image are now what my mask is. So if I turn on this bottom part here, I now have the highlights that are noise reduced, and then the shadows that are noise reduced. And with that done, let's go ahead and hit Shift C. And I already have this input, but I have a 4:5 aspect ratio. So I'm gonna just go ahead and crop this image a little bit, just so I have less pixels to work with. And then the last thing is, let's just go ahead and get rid of this background. Now I can get rid of the background in several ways, but given that my hair is kind of crazy, I'm going to get rid of it by adding a black background. So I'm going to hit Control Shift D. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm going to hit Control Shift N and add in a new layer. And then I'll click this little black and white toggle here in order to reset my colors to black and white, and then hit Shift B in order to grab my paint bucket tool and then fill that top layer with black. Now I'm going to decrease the opacity, and then I'm going to add in a white full opacity layer image mask. And then using my paintbrush tool that I select by hitting B on my that I select by hitting P on my keyboard, I can increase the size of my brush and increase the force, something like that. And then I can actually just go ahead and paint this mask. And now with that painted, I'm going to alt click on my image mask and then hit F on my keyboard to grab my lasso tool, and I'll just select around what I want to delete and then hit Shift B to grab my paint bucket tool and just fill that whole area with black, and then Control Shift A. And there we go. So now I'm going to alt click on that image mask again, and you can see that I've got some issues here, like I wasn't very accurate, and this is where having a selection can work to our benefit. So I'm going to grab my lasso tool and I'm going to turn on feather edges with a radius of 3, and I'm just going to select, and then I'll hit P on my keyboard and X in order to switch my color from black to white, and then let me just fill this in and do the same on this side. I'll hit F on my keyboard and P, just fill that in with white, and then I actually, you can see there's some of that black that's coming in on my face on this side that might look good or might not, but I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of it for the time being. So I hit Control I in order to invert my selection and invert the color to black, and then I can just go ahead and paint that out. Hit Control Shift A. I'm gonna decrease my brush size and just kind of paint around my ear here, and then I'll select the black layer and increase that to 100% so I can see exactly what's going on now. So this doesn't look bad, but I find in portraits like this that have a black background, it's better to have a nice gradient that leads from your subject into the black background, so it's not so harsh like this. So I'm going to decrease my force to something really low, maybe something like 7 or 8, and increase my brush size to something quite large. And then using the color white on my black background image layer mask, I'm just going to go ahead and kind of run the brush over some of these parts where the color is a little bit harsher, or the edge is a little harsher. See, I got rid of that, but actually I probably should have kept it. And I'm gonna do that over here. Sometimes you might need to decrease your brush size. And you'll notice I'm just putting the edge of the brush over the edge of where I'm trying to blend. I might really increase this to something big. Just kind of paint some of this a little bit. Okay, so there we go. Let me paint some of this out just a hair. Oops. So now that we have this, the last thing I can do is just go ahead and merge this down. So merge down, and then grab a color curves and just give this one final adjustment now that we have the background. And I think that looks pretty okay. Anyway, I hope that this has been helpful to you guys. I sure had fun working on this little portrait here. I hope everybody is staying safe, and I will see you guys next time.